Yo, how's it going guys? AdamX here, hope you're all doing well, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to optimize Windows 10 for gaming and performance in 2021. This guide will include some new optimizations and a lot of new tweaks that will help boost your FPS, lower input lag, and make your system overall much more responsive. I've been working on registry files and tweaks for months just to get this video ready. And also guys, I highly recommend you all to clean reinstall Windows 10 following my guide that I made yesterday that I will also leave the link for down below in the description. As clean reinstalling Windows can help a ton with performance. So with that being said guys, enjoy the video. Alright, so first thing you wanna do is download the new Windows 10 optimization pack by me. This link will be down below in the description. After you download this, you'll need to extract it with 7-zip or WinRAR, and after that, just double click on it. And in here, you're going to see a lot of folders that I numbered, so it's easy for you to follow. Wanna start by the first folder, and in here, before doing anything, you wanna double click on create a restore point. Then on the left, you wanna scroll down till you find the drive that has system beside it, which means it's your boot drive. Click on it, then click create, and then you wanna name the restore point, basically just anything, and then click create. After it's done, you can click OK. And now we have a system restore point in case you wanna revert back for any reason. After you've done that, you wanna now double click on uninstall apps you don't need. And in here, make sure to uninstall every single program you don't use, and don't keep anything that you don't use just chilling right there for no reason. Also, if you have pre-installed apps and bloatware, then you can follow my debloating guide. Its link will be down below in the description. It basically guides you on how to clean Windows from pre-installed programs. So after you've uninstalled all the apps you don't need, you can exit out of settings. And now you wanna double click on 3 startup apps. And in here, basically make sure to disable everything unless there is a program like MSI Afterburner that you need to auto start to apply your overclock. But other than that, please make sure to disable everything else because this can help speed up your system a lot. So after you've disabled every program you don't need starting up automatically, you can just exit out of Task Manager, and now you wanna double click on 4 auto runs. AutoRuns is basically a program that shows you every little thing that starts as soon as your PC launches. In here, you wanna go into the log on tab and basically just uncheck everything you don't need launching when you open your PC, just as we did in Task Manager. After that, you can go into the Everything tab, and if you feel pretty confident about what you're doing and you're sure you're not going to mess anything up, you can disable whatever you want to prevent it from launching as soon as your PC starts. So after you're done in here, you can just exit out from AutoRuns, and now you wanna double click on 5 disable UAC, click yes and then OK. We are disabling UAC because we're going to run some batch files that won't run with UAC enabled. So after you run it, you just need to restart your PC for it to apply, and when you do that, you just want to come back here. And when you're back here, you now want to double click on disable Windows updates. So I've already made a whole video about this, but as a sum up, Windows updates revert optimizations, and you definitely don't want to optimize your whole PC every time Windows updates. And also these updates worsen performance as Windows keeps putting out updates that just ruin gaming performance. And lastly, you definitely don't want a random update just running at the middle of your game, since that can ruin your ping and gameplay overall. So simply you just want to double click on it, then it's gonna disable the Windows update service. Then it's gonna simply add the registry dewars that will disable automatic updates. And when it's done, simply just click enter or any key. And in case you wanna enable updates back again, there is going to be a revert pack down below in the description. So after you're done with this folder, you can now go back and now go into the registry and BCD tweaks folder. And in here, let me start by explaining the BCD tweaks we're going to apply. So basically, there's a lot more BCD tweaks that you can do in here, but I'm honestly just putting the most effective ones and the ones that are just gonna turn out good for most people. So the first command basically disables dynamic tick, which is a power saving feature that causes latency issues if enabled, so obviously we disable it. And then for this command, this will basically make sure that HPET, also known as High Precision Event Timer, is disabled, which lowers latency quite a lot. But you need to have HPET enabled in BIOS, because if you don't, then you might get stutters. If you never went into BIOS or disabled HPET there, then you're fine. And if you don't have HPET in BIOS, then you're fine as well, since that means it's automatically enabled. Lastly, for the Disable Synthetic Timers command, this one pretty much just explains itself. It will disable synthetic timers, which helps out a ton with latency, will make your mouse feel much more smoother, and will also reduce stuttering. So to apply that, you simply just want to double click on it. It's gonna say operation completed successfully for 2 commands, and for the HPET command, it might say error not found, which means HPET is disabled already. So after that, you can exit out of command prompt, And now for the registry tweaks, registry file. And in here I basically start by disabling power throttling. So this feature is supposed to improve power consumption by reducing the amount of power a process can use. Sometimes it does that for games, which decreases performance, so we disable it with this registry dword. And then for the MMCSS tweak, probably everyone knows these tweaks by now, and just recently I found out from a really good tweaker called TimeCard that disabling network throttling index hires DPC latency, while as it's already known, disabling it improves your network performance, but that comes at the cost of increased DPC latency, which in the case of gaming is more important. So in here I'm just putting the default value, which is going to be best for DPC latency. Then for system responsiveness, this will basically allow games to utilize more than 80% of CPU usage if they need to, which will improve performance. Then for these ones, they basically are hiring your GPU priority to specific games, which will improve performance. And then for disable full screen optimizations globally, so this will basically prevent desktop composition, also known as DWM, from interfering with your game, which will make your game in exclusive full screen mode, which improves input lag and makes your game much more smoother. For it to work though, you need to be playing in full screen mode in your game settings, and also you need to disable full screen optimizations on the game extension file by just opening your game and then right clicking on your taskbar and click task manager, and then in here simply just right click on your game. I don't have any game open right now, so I'm just going to do OBS Studio. You just want to right click on it and click open file location. Then you want to right click on the file it highlighted, click properties, go into the compatibility tab, check disable full screen optimizations, then click change high DPI scaling behavior and check override high DPI scaling behavior, click OK, and then click OK. But I definitely don't want to do that for OBS, so I'm just gonna put it back. Also keep in mind that exclusive full screen doesn't work on DirectX 12 games, which is really unfortunate. To make sure that your game is in exclusive full screen mode, you can open your game and then try using your volume keys to higher or lower your volume, and if it shows the volume bar on the game, then that means you're not in exclusive full screen mode, but if it doesn't, then you're good. After that, for the decreased processes, kill time and menu show delay, there is nothing really to explain here. It simply just lowers the amount of time it takes to end a process or a service, and will simply just make Windows feel a lot more responsive. After that, for disable auto maintenance, so this is basically a process that runs every day randomly while you're using your PC, can run updates and consume your PC resources while you're playing games, which all can decrease performance. And then finally, for disable hibernation, we just disable it since it causes a ton of instability issues. So now to apply all that, you simply just want to double click on the file, click yes, and then okay. And now you want to go back and now go into the Windows settings folder. So before I explain what it does, I just want to say that if you're a tweaker or optimizer that is going to use or redistribute this registry file in any way, please give me proper credit since I've worked on it for literally months. This rec file will basically optimize every single setting in here that needs to be changed, which can save you all a ton of time. I've worked on it for a couple of months, but at the end of the day it was worth since this can help you all out. So now let me explain what the settings in it do. So starting off by the accounts tab, it's gonna disable settings syncing since you don't want features like that just running randomly out of nowhere. And then it goes into the personalization tab and disables transparency, which will make Windows feel more responsive. And then it goes into the gaming tab and graphics settings in system tab to disable game bar and game DVR since they add a ton of input lag and cause a ton of performance issues. Then it basically enables game mode and hardware accelerated GPU scheduling. So hardware accelerated GPU scheduling is basically a new feature in Windows for anything above Windows 10 version 2004, and this feature seems to have helped improve FPS slightly by about 5 to 10 FPS in some games, and based on what Microsoft claims, it's going to even improve by time. Also keep in mind it only works on Windows 10 2004 and above, and Nvidia 10 series GPUs and above, and lastly AMD 5000 GPUs and above. Then we basically disable variable refresh rate since it adds input lag, and then we go into the ease of access tab and disable all of the ease of access features. These can interfere with your keybinds a lot and they have really annoying pop-ups. After that, for the privacy tab, all the settings in here are going to disable all the telemetry features, which you definitely would want to do since telemetry is just Windows tracking and spying on the stuff you do like app installations and search results. And then for the app permissions tab, this is honestly personal preference, so I recommend you do this manually on your own from settings, but I'm just going to do 4 settings, which I highly recommend, which is basically disabling applications from accessing your location, your app diagnostics from other apps, your personal account info, and your notifications so you don't pop up while you're playing games. After that, for the disable let unnecessary apps run in the background, this will basically prevent unnecessary apps from opening automatically out of nowhere while you're playing games to prevent them from decreasing your performance and adding up input lag. Then we scroll down and here are some extras that will also disable suggested content and pre-installed apps from showing up, because you definitely don't want a random advertisement in your file explorer or start menu just showing up like that. And it will basically disable every suggestions feature in Windows 10, and then below are just exactly the same thing. After that, to apply all these settings, you simply just want to double click on it, click yes, and then OK, and now all your Windows settings are optimized. After that, you want to go back, and now go into the Control Panel folder. And then in here, I basically cover optimizing the most important settings in Control Panel. And then in here, you want to double click on Change Sound Settings, and then you want to go into the Playback tab, and then you want to double click on your headset, go into the Enhancements tab if you have it, and make sure to disable all enhancements as they can cause a ton of input lag, and it's actually so annoying. After that, you want to go into the Advanced tab, and then you want to change your sound quality to 16-bit. After that, click Apply and click OK, and then simply just click OK again. After that, you want to double click on M1 Mouse Acceleration, and then in here, you want to make sure to uncheck Enhance Mouse Pointer Precision, and to make sure that this slider is 6 out of 11. After that, you want to click Apply and then click OK, and then you want to double click on M2 Mark C Windows 10 Mouse Fix. Huge shout out to Mark C for this mouse fix. This will basically give you one-to-one mouse input, which will make your mouse feel much better and will be much more responsive. After that, you wanna double click on performance options, and then in here you wanna click on adjust for best performance, and then you can check smooth edges of screen fonts option, and you can also check show thumbnails instead of icons. And another one I like to personally do is show window contents while dragging. After that, click apply and then click OK. After you're done with this folder, you can now go back and now go into the 5 power plan folder. And in here, you're going to see my own personal power plan that I made. I've worked on this power plan for quite a long time, and in it, I basically go over the most important settings and adjust them all for best possible FPS and input latency. So to import it into your system, you simply just want to double click on one import Atomex power plan, and simply this batch file I made is going to move the power plan to your C drive, and then it's gonna import the power plan from there, and then the power plan is gonna delete itself from the C drive after it's imported. Also, something I recommend you all to do is to delete all the other power plans, since for some reason Windows switches to a random power plan, and you definitely don't want it switching to power saving like that out of nowhere. So just double click on delete other power plans, and they are gonna get deleted. And if for some reason you want them back, you can double click on stock power plans and double click on run this server power plans deletion, and all these power plans are gonna get added back. So after you're done with this folder, you can now go back and now go into the GPU settings folder. Then basically go to the folder with your GPU brand name. So I have an NVIDIA GPU, so I'm gonna double click on NVIDIA settings, and simply you just wanna copy these settings into your NVIDIA control panel. So to open it, you simply just wanna right click on your desktop and click NVIDIA control panel. Then you wanna go into the manage 3D settings tab and simply just copy these settings and also read these notes, since some settings are gonna depend on your system. Also, if you're on PC, double click on the unhide silk smoothness registry file to unhide the setting. And after you're done copying the settings for your GPU, go into the cleanup folder. And then in here, you simply just want to double click on delete temporary files. So this pretty much explains itself. It will basically just clean your temp files, which usually take a lot of space. Then for delete log files, simply just do the same thing by double clicking. And then it's going to delete as much log files as it can, which can also free up a lot of space. After it's done, you now want to double click on delete Windows Update cached files. It's gonna basically disable the Windows Update service first, so it's able to delete them. And when it's done, just click any key and click enter. So after that, you now want to double click on forward disk cleanup, then click OK. And in here, you simply just want to check everything you know you don't need. And after that, simply just click OK, then click delete files and let it clean them. And after it's done, you now want to go back, and now you want to go into the unwanted services folder. So basically in here, we're going to disable unnecessary services from Windows, since these can ruin our latency quite a lot. So just right click on power on and click properties. And in here, for some of you, it's gonna show unblock. Just check it and then click apply and OK. And then you want to hold and drag the disabled diagnostics telemetry services rec file over to power on. Then lift off your finger, click yes, and then OK. Also, as I said earlier in the video, telemetry services are simply just Windows spying and tracking on the stuff you do, which you definitely don't want. After that, you wanna do the same thing for disable extra unnecessary services. Just drag it, click yes, and then OK. So the services in this rec file are basically the most useless services in Windows, so no point in keeping them running, just hiring our latency. So after doing that, you can now do the same for the optional registry files if you want. I personally don't use any of these features, so I'm just gonna disable them. And after that, you want to go into the Disable Anti-Malware Service Executable folder, and in here you're going to see a registry file that allows you to disable this annoying service. So this is the one and only service that uses a ton of RAM usage and can also use a ton of CPU and disk usage on older systems, and I highly recommend you disable it since I've seen it causing stutters for some people. And as a replacement for it and Windows Defender, you can download Malwarebytes as a replacement. Simply just right click on Power On, click Properties, make sure to check Unblock if you have it, click OK, then you want to drag the registry file over to Power On, click Yes, and then OK. So that was it for the video, guys. I hope you all enjoyed it and that it helped you all out. Make sure to like and subscribe if this video helped you. Stay safe, love you all, and I'll see you all in the next one.